We need the ocean. Everybody feels better when they're near the water. It's healing. It provides life. I don't know, I've always loved the ocean. People see the ocean and you don't see the problems in it necessarily. Marine debris, ocean acidification, freshwater inputs, it's kind of endless issues. But when you start to recognize those and then you make a linkage to something we can all relate to, like land and the bears and where we live, I think that's really significant. My name's Heather Coletti and I'm a marine ecologist with the National Park Service.
Humans are creatures of the land, and while a lot of us love the ocean, we have a tendency to go to the beach and look out and just see a bunch of water and leave it at that, as interesting as that might be. But we are still intrinsically connected to the organisms that live in the ocean. My name is Benjamin Pister, and I'm the Director and Research Coordinator for the Ocean Alaska Science and Learning Center.
I think the overarching concept was to really highlight some of the linkages between terrestrial ecosystems and marine ecosystems, and how those two, that a lot of times we normally think are separate, really do rely on each other. And so we're looking at how bears, a charismatic megafauna in the terrestrial system, utilizes the marine system for survival.
Bears like to eat the clams. The clams are susceptible to a lot of different impacts. We're worried about oil spills, we're worried about climate change, we're worried about ocean acidification, we're worried about the number of clams people are taking. And if those impacts are detrimental to the clams, what does that mean for the bears? Ocean acidification, personally, that's the one that I worry about the most. It kind of gets lumped in with climate change a lot, and they're certainly both caused by excess CO2 in the atmosphere. CO2 dissolves in the ocean, which lowers the pH of the ocean and creates more acidic conditions. Any organism that builds a shell is going to have a hard time with those conditions. And clams have shells, mussels have shells. So within our lifetimes, they're going to experience conditions that are going to be really hard to deal with. That's a big concern.
So we're collecting bivalves, so that could be your clam species and mussels, and we're collecting them from various locations on the coast. And we're just digging them, really, in the case of mussels, you know, we can really just pull them off the rocks.
And then we go out and try to find clam shows or clam holes in the mud. And then we either use a shovel or what's called a clam gun, which is just a tube that we push down in the mud, and then there's a hole you plug with your finger. It creates a vacuum and you can pull it out. And if you do it right, there's a clam there.
We bring them back to the boat to be processed. And that at this point, what we're taking are hemolymph samples, mantle and gill samples, and then the whole clam or bivalve mussel. And those are being preserved and brought back to the labs for further analysis.
In the lab, we're measuring the rate they express certain genes. So if they're responding to heat or they're responding to the presence of oil, they're going to use certain genes a lot more often. And we can measure how much they use those genes by measuring their amount of RNA that is produced to make the proteins that those genes code for.
You know, if the stressor is high enough that you're actually removing large proportions or large amounts of these animals as a food resource, I think it could have large impacts, even on a generalist predator like a bear, you know, that can eat essentially anything they want. I mean, if these animals are relying on this relatively easy food source for them to get, and then it's gone, they're going to have to spend energy looking elsewhere. And that could change how productive they are or how long they survive. And that could have real consequences.
Being able to experience these places definitely increases the respect and the affection, the love, and the desire to be good stewards. People will hopefully act in a way to help protect them better and ultimately encourage our policymakers to make decisions to help protect the land for the long run.
I think some people are disconnected from the oceans and they don't realize how much we or other animals rely on it, you know, to survive, and to take something that everyone loves, like bears, and make that linkage, you know, I hope highlights to managers how important our oceans are and that we should be actively engaged in monitoring their health and managing them, you know, as one whole unit.